What's good, everybody? It's your boy Odell. We all know what this is about. But before we jump on this, I want to say Merry Christmas to everybody. All my fellow collectors from YouTube, Facebook, Sideshow Freaks, you guys rock. Appreciate the messages that I got in concerns of my mom. Nanny D, Christine, Carlos, Seb, a couple others. Appreciate that. She's doing much better. Believe it or not, she's upstairs now, wrapping gifts up. So I'm just going to take it one day at a time and just get her back up to 100%. That's all I can do. It's been a rough week. I'm still tired from the drive. I had a drive from Ohio to Illinois to get my dad, and then from Illinois to Memphis to go pick her up. I did all the driving, even driving back, so I'm still trying to recover from it. So that's why it just seems like I'm so tired when I do these videos. So I said a couple weeks ago, for Christmas, I'm gonna give this away to a well-deserving fellow collector. But before we jump on to this, I'm gonna have you guys wait a little bit longer. I know the anticipation. Everybody wants to know who this is going to, but you gotta wait a couple more minutes. I fucked up. I said I was gonna give away two figures, Bruce Wayne. In the midst of me rushing out of the house, hitting the road to get to my mom's, I left the figure at home, and I don't have it here to display to show you guys, but I have the individual that I'm going to announce that I'm going to give that to. There were three people. Clipper King, because I don't think he has a Bruce Wayne figure. I know he has the Batman, but he doesn't actually have a whole Bruce Wayne figure. Seb and Nanny D. Now, the reason why I zeroed it down to one and that individual is Nanny D. Why did I zero it down to Nanny D? Well, here's the thing. Seb and Nanny D were giving me shit about this Bruce Wayne head that I was going to sell it about a month ago. And they saw the paint job. And they just did not like it at all. I mean, they kept giving me shit about it. So, Seb, I know he doesn't paint. And I know Clipper King, he doesn't, you know, paint neither. Nanny D does. He's a top-notch paint artist. And I figure it can use the Nanny D touch. So the figure is yours. Don't PM me talking about it needs, you can give it to somebody else. Somebody else well deserving. You're good. Nah, brother. You talked shit about the paint job. Therefore, it's yours. And you can give it the Nanny D touch and add it to the rest of your collection there. So no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's yours. So with that being said, I'm not going back home until like next week, so I'll probably do a video in the new year. This is my last video for 2012, so I'll show everybody the finished Bruce Wayne before I send it off to Nanny, and hopefully Nanny, I'm not even going to say hopefully. I know Nanny's going to look at it as soon as he gets it in the mail. He's going to look at that head and just be like, I can't display it with it looking like this. I got to give it the Nanny D touch. So I hope he does do it and show a before and after video for that. With that being said, I know I've been making you guys wait on this bad boy here. And like I said, this individual didn't win this figure. This individual, I felt, deserved and earned this figure. And the person that I'm going to give it to Autobahn John. A lot of people know who Autobahn John is. Some of you guys may not know. That's his name on YouTube. Why am I giving it to Autobahn John? There's a little story behind this. When I was living in Hawaii, I saw his YouTube channel. When he did a video on his life-size Christopher Reeve Superman, which fucking rocks. I love it. He painted it. He built it up himself. He did a life-size Batman, Michael Keaton, and he did a life-size Terminator, Arnold Schwarzenegger. And he also does 1/6 scale customizing. He sculpts and he paints. And when I first saw them, I'll admit, I thought some of his figures looked funny, and I laughed. And this was me maybe 2 months into collecting, and I didn't know better. And I was wrong for that. I was a huge dick for laughing at that, because I realized that, you know what, no matter how many people may not like his work and may find it bad or, you know, not up to perfection level, that dude still keeps going. He shouts me out every time he does a video, and he keeps going. And I admire that about him, that no matter what, it's something that he loves to do. And I think all of us as collectors should embrace what he does, no matter if it's his level of perfection or Hot Toys level of perfection. The thing is, he tries and he continues to try to better himself, and that fucking rocks. Because I can't paint worth a shit and I can't sculpt worth a shit. So some of those talents I don't have, and he's getting better. And I think the more that he keeps at it, the better that he'll get. And I know he had to take a break in collecting, because I remember he mentioned he had a roommate that skipped out on him and left him with the rent and everything. So he had to kind of had to put a hold on the collecting game so he can handle business and get those bills paid. And I know he said Hot Toys, he really doesn't collect that many Hot Toys because of the fact that it's, you know, kind of not within his budget, which is why he customized his own figures. So this is from me to him. Bruh, I know you love the Terminator. This is yours. You fucking rock. You deserve this. I know you don't get the respect that you do on Sideshow Freaks, neither do I. Who gives a fuck? We keep doing our thing, keep pressing forward. And even on YouTube, you got haters just like I do. Keep going, keep pressing forward. And that's what I respect about him. And you know what? The whole 2-day thing, you got 2 days, is not a contest. This is a gift, and you earn it. So you take your time whenever you see the video, and know that, you know, this bad boy is coming to you. I don't care if it takes a week or 2 weeks. When you see it, you can hit me up with your address, and I'll send this bad boy right out to you. But yeah, y'all, I mean, this, when it comes down to this collecting thing, you gotta embrace folks no matter if they're good or if they're not good at doing their type of skill when it comes down to custom work. And his work, is it Denny Kim style? Is it Sarong style? Rayman style? No. You know, it's John style, and he appreciates it, and that's really that all that matters. He doesn't sell them to anybody. He just does it for his own collection, and I think that fucking rocks. I'm going to try and do my own little display and customize it myself and see how that comes out. At first, I wasn't going to do it, but you know, when I sat back and I look at the things that he does, and I'm like, you know what, I'm going to give it a shot. If he can do it, I know I can do it. And that's what it came down to. I know a lot of guys, you know, a lot of you guys out there that have Hot Toys, massive collection. And yeah, this could have came to you, but I think Autobot John is more deserving for this. Therefore, that is the reason why I select him to give this gift to. So if you haven't seen his channel, it's Autobot John. No thanks have to come to me at all, man. If anything, I say thank you, Autobot John, just for what he does. And he clearly shows to everybody that, hey, it may not be the quality that you guys are looking for, but I'm going to keep doing what I'm going to keep doing, and I'm only going to improve and get better. So, yeah, this is yours, man. Hit me up, and I'll get this out to you. Don't paint it, though. Just leave it be. Just take it out and display it, but don't paint on it. Don't. It's fine just the way it is. That's an inside joke. I'm sure he'll understand what I'm talking about. But, man, I'm fucking exhausted, and I was going to watch Ted, but I think I'm going to save that. I can't even save it for tomorrow. I got to go take my brother-in-law to go see The Hobbit. That's going to be like 3 times that I've seen that movie. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it without falling asleep, because that, when you drive for 10 hours out the day and then you end up sleeping over at your cousin's house on the couch, get up in the morning and hit the road coming back another 6 hours, fucking exhausting. And then coming home to a 2-year-old, exhausting. So I think I'm going to crash. It is 9 minutes. It is 9 minutes Central Time before Christmas hits. So I'm about to load this video up. John, bro, this is yours. You guys rock. I'm out. I'm going to bed, and I will see you guys next year video-wise, but I'll be posting shit on Facebook left and right. So, yeah, I'll see you guys next year. Peace.